Okay, good morning everybody, and welcome to this year's Remote Remembrance Day service. In normal circumstances, we would all gather here by our Manchester Bee to show our respect in a moment of silent reflection for those people that have paid their the ultimate sacrifice in making sure that we might live a free life. But this year it's going to be slightly different. So it's a remote service and a remote remembrance reflection that we'll be doing. Firstly, I'd like to introduce our foundation department who've collaborated to sign Vera Lynn's We'll Meet Again.
Folks that I know, tell them I won't be long. They'll be happy to know that as you saw me go, I was singing this song. We'll meet again, don't know when, don't know when.
Thank you very much, Foundation Department, that was excellent. I'd now like to take the opportunity to welcome Reverend Deacon Catherine Darby, who served in the Royal Signals, to say some words of reflection on our behalf.
Good morning. I'd like to begin, if I may, with a very short reading from the Bible. It's Micah, chapter 4, verses 1 to 8. In the mountain of the Lord, his temple will be established. It will be raised above the hills and people will stream to it. Many nations will come and say, "Come, let us go up to the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the God of Jacob, He will teach us his ways so that we may walk in his paths. The law will go out from Zion, the word of the Lord from Jerusalem. He will judge between many peoples and will settle disputes for strong nations far and wide. They will beat their swords into plowshares and their spears into pruning hooks. Nation will not take up sword against nation, nor will they train for war anymore. This day is quite hard for me because all my life I've been connected with the military. My grandfather was a survivor of the Somme. He was wounded. He bore the scars on his chest and in his chest. He always suffered the effects of being gassed in the trenches. My father and my uncles all served in the army. Until his death a couple of years ago, my father was heavily involved in the Old Comrades Association, where they would meet often to commemorate and remember. I now have the honour of being an old comrade myself because I served in the army and I've been in conflict situations. Despite the computer games and war games we play, despite all the documentaries and reconstructions, war is indescribably cruel, even when it's dressed up as it is these days as conflicts. The memories of the things I saw in the refugee camps will never leave me. Some of you may have memories of your own. My military connections don't end up there. My elder brother served for 35 years in the Royal Artillery. My younger brother served for 22 years. But the hardest and probably most personal experience, though, is that of a mother. My son joined the army when he was 17. And seeing him onto that train was the hardest thing I have ever done. I've seen him off to conflict, and I've stood proudly as he received his medal. And I've felt shame and guilt in my pride as another mother collected the medal on behalf of her son who didn't come back. So today is a special day, a day to remember all the people and the animals who didn't come back, and those who came back damaged. The reading that I read from Micah isn't about remembering, though. It's a vision. It's a vision of peace. A vision of a time when disputes are settled peacefully. Weapons of war will become unnecessary because war will have vanished from the earth. We are challenged today to work towards that vision of peace, and education is the key. When we have all, as a people and nations, heard and learned the message from Micah, only then will we see an end to conflict. I used to teach primary school, and when children asked why we had wars, I used to tell them that it was because of bullies. Because bullies want what someone else has. We all know and experience bullies and being bullied in school, in the workplace, in government, because there are always people who are not satisfied with what they have. And it's up to us, people like us, to follow the example that's been set to us by those who stood up to bullies in the past, and whose lives we remember today. A lot of them didn't have a choice. We are so fortunate in this country that there is no forced conscription as there is in many others. None of you will be forced into military service. You won't be made to fight a war. People at the moment are complaining because they've been asked to wear a mask. They need to be thankful. We need to be thankful that we're not forced to wear a uniform to be sent out to die. That's because the people we remember today did answer the call to defend our freedom. The animals who were sent to the war didn't have a choice. And remember, it's not just like war horse. Animals are still being sent and still sacrificed today. But this college is an example of animal training. Today, pouched rats are being used to find unexploded mines Dogs are widely used by the military and the police forces, as are horses. And sadly, they're still injured and killed defending this country's freedoms. And we remember them and their trainers today. The wars and conflicts were fought to give people freedoms, to practice religion, any religion or no religion. We're free to express our opinions, and there's a lot of that around at the moment. Because of COVID-19, we think that we're in difficult times, and indeed we are. But I just want to show you something. This is my father's, my late father's, regimental tie. It's brown, red, and green. It symbolises the motto of the Tank Corps: through the mud, through the blood, to the green fields beyond. And I suggest to us that this applies today. Mud and dirt we see all around us. Heartache and bloodshed are always on our televisions. But green is the colour of hope. And that's what I want to leave to you today. We go through the mud, we go through the blood, but then we find the green fields of happiness. Thank you.
Thanks, Catherine, for those very personal and profound reflections. We're very grateful for you coming today. Thank you very much for sharing that with us. Okay, next I'd like to introduce Courtney Green, who's an animal management learner, and she's going to read In Flanders Fields by John McCrae.
The poppies blow, between the crosses row on row that mark our place, and in the sky the larks still bravely sing and fly, scarce heard amid the guns below. We are the dead, short days ago we lived, felt down, saw the sunset glow, loved and were loved, and now we lie in Flanders fields. Take up our quarrel with the foe, to you from the falling hands we throw. The torch be yours to hold it high. If you break faith with us who die, we shall not sleep though poppies grow in Flanders fields.
Thanks very much, Courtney. Our next reading comes from Conor Leon, who's also Life Sciences, and he's going to read I Will Remember by Alice Day.
At 11 o'clock, I say thank you to the fallen, the injured, the dead. I wasn't there, didn't witness the horror, the fear, and the dread. I wasn't there to wave them on, the soldiers, the boys, and the men. I wasn't there to sing or cheer, to wave again and again. I didn't see the terror, or the fear, or the pride in their eye. As those brave warriors left us, they weren't afraid to die. But at 11 o'clock, I'll stay silent, and I'll wear my poppy with pride. The fallen will never leave us, they will always walk at my side. They didn't lose their lives for nothing, they gave up theirs for me, and so I'll be thankful to the men I'll never see. So be proud to wear a poppy, be proud to remember this day. Learn from the lessons of the past, they will never go away.
Thank you, Connor. And finally, our reading comes from Jake Tierney, and it's a poem by our very own Jen Candela Alfonso called A Minute Silence.
A Minute Silence. I'm not that good at silences. I tend to stamp and huff. I know that it's important, but I'm not patient enough. I'm not built to be silent. I'm built to take the strain. I'm built to carry soldiers off into war again. Could the war have ended without us, the steeds that stood by you? We may not have volunteered, but we gave our lives up too. We may not be good at silences, but we're loyal, fast and brave, and we've no way of knowing how many lives we saved. 10 million soldiers lost their lives, 8 million horses fell, but in those 4 short years we know we served our masters well. So think of us, the ones that died, the horses who never came home. There's no more pain and no fear here in Flanders Field, we roam.
Okay, thank you, Jake. And I'd now like to invite you all to join us in a silent moment of reflection where we're going to take a couple of minutes to remember those soldiers and indeed animals that gave their lives during the Great Wars. Whilst that happens, the lane of our two Rees will be taken by two Uniformed Public Services learners, Megan Dunn and Katie Heathcote. Okay, thank you everybody. And to conclude our remembrance service this year, I'd like to invite Catherine back while we bow our heads in prayer.
If you feel able, please join us in this prayer. We pray for all of creation that suffers as a result of conflict, and ask that God may give us peace. We pray for the servicemen and women and all the animals who have died in the violence of war, each one remembered and known to God. We pray for all members of the armed forces who are in danger this day, remembering family, friends, and all who pray for their safe return. May God give them peace. We pray for civilian women, children, and men whose lives are disfigured by war or terror, calling to mind in penitence the anger and hatred of humanity. We pray for peacemakers and peacekeepers who seek to keep this world secure and free. We pray for all those who bear the burden and privilege of leadership, political, military and religious, asking for gifts of wisdom and resolve in the search for reconciliation and peace. And God of truth and justice, we hold before you those whose memory we cherish and those whose names we will never know. Help us to lift our eyes above the torment of this broken world and grant us the grace to pray for those who would wish us harm. As we honour the past, may we put our faith in your future, now and forever. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore.
Thank you very much for everybody who's contributed to our service today. I hope you take the time to reflect on those. I know it's very distant for some of you, but I'm sure it's very, very real. And I'm sure you've got lots of personal connections. So I hope you've enjoyed our service, and we look forward to seeing you soon. Thank you.